Rates on fixed mortgages dropped to their lowest levels in decades this week after the Federal Reserve unveiled a massive bond buying program to help push economic growth. Mortgage buyer Freddie Mac says the average rate for 30-year fixed loans fell to 4.17%. That is the lowest on records dating back to 1971. A home ownership versus renting. With so many people upside down on their mortgages these days, is it a better deal to buy or to rent? Our Project Economy coverage continues tonight with News 8's Jim Keithley, who has a closer look at the pros and the cons of home ownership. Jim?
Well, Tracy, some good arguments on both sides of this national debate. We don't have to tell you about the thousands of people right here in Maine who are struggling to pay their mortgages right now. Experts say home ownership is still the way to go, even now. The missing piece to this real estate puzzle, according to the experts, homeowners aren't thinking long term, which is what's needed to get that return on investment.
And here's the kitchen.
Well, how long have you been here?
Been here 18 years.
Renting?
Renting.
And you love it?
I love it.
James Griffin has been renting this tidy little home in Portland for years. He says he wouldn't have it any other way. 12 years ago, he was in the process of buying a duplex, but it wasn't meant to be.
Got to the closing table and the sellers didn't show up, which was actually a good thing for me because the week after that, I had a major heart attack and a quadruple bypass. So even if I had closed that day, being off work for 6 to 8 to 10 months, I would have lost the house anyway.
Renting, he says, provides a sense of security and peace of mind, not having to worry about the expensive mortgage, taxes, and maintenance fees.
Home ownership is not a match for everyone. It is the American dream, but it's just not for everyone.
We're teaching a weekend in Danvers. So
real estate investor Linda Huskinen says home ownership is still the best investment people can make.
Because all you have as a tenant is a pile of rent receipts. And what will you have at any point in time is equity built up in your home.
If I'd have bought a $250,000 condo, now if I had to sell it, I might get $125,000 out of it. That's not a good investment. Not for me.
Huskinen has spent 23 years investing in real estate. She says she's amassed incredible wealth by buying and selling at the right time and now shares her knowledge with others, especially those who got into trouble.
And a lot of people who went into home ownership went in over their heads. There was some crazy lending practices that were going on, and we're seeing the results of that, where people just didn't do the math before they got in.
Huskinen provides a simple formula that potential home buyers should use to ensure the home they're buying is one they can afford.
No more than 25% of your income, because usually with mortgage guidelines, they want 30, no more than 30 or 33. So if you can do it 20 to 25, that's usually a pretty good ratio. You'll be okay.
Another bit of advice, now is still a good time to buy.
When you find something in a nice location that's a decent property that fits you and your family's needs and that you can afford it easily, and I mean easily, then you buy it. And in this market, you can do that.
So you wanted to see Rose Station Road?
We didn't tell you that James Griffin is not only a renter, but a licensed real estate broker.
I've been a broker for 26 years, right here in town.
You sell people the American dream.
I try to, I certainly do.
Do you tell them that you rent?
If they ask, I do. Yeah. And the reasons why.
Proud to sell the American dream, but happy to be a renter.
Well, the money that I save in this type of rent goes to my retirement. So that when I'm not working, I can still afford this. That's the key.
Now, in case you're wondering, Griffin's rent was $550 a month when he moved in 18 years ago. It has gone up a bit. He's now paying $750 a month now. If he had bought that condo, he tells me, he estimates that his mortgage, taxes, and condo fees would be double what he's paying now. Live in the studio, Jim Keithley, News 8.